Okay, good morning to you all, and welcome to this lecture number 3. And in this lecture, we will study Kirchhoff's current law, popularly called as KCL. And basically, it is applied on a node. So, Kirchhoff voltage applies to a node in a circuit, okay? And what it basically says is, if you see at a particular node, and sum up all the currents at that particular node, okay, taking into account the directions of the currents, then the sum would equal to zero. So what it means in actual sense, we can see here. For example, in this circuit, if you see, here we are considering two nodes are there, node number 1, and this is node number 2. And at both nodes, some currents are going in and coming out. So we are considering the circuit in the sense of KCL, or in the node perception of the matter, okay? So we are seeing the circuit from a node point of view. So at this node 1, if you see, the currents coming are I1, I2, then I6, I7, I8. These are the currents coming at node 2, that they are connected to node 2. At node 1, all these currents I1, I2, I6, I7 and I8 are coming or going out, whatever it is, are related to node 1. And similarly, I2, I5, I4 and I3 are connected or related to node 3. So these currents are either coming or going out of nodes. So if we talk in terms of Kirchhoff's node analysis or Kirchhoff's current law, then I can write a KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, at node 1. What it says is, if you see this node 1, so it says that I1 is coming in, so we give a positive sign to it, okay, positive sign for incoming current, okay. So if the current is coming in, we take positive sign, so I1 is positive. Then I2, if you see again, if you see the direction of the current, again I2 is again positive, I6 is again positive, I7 is positive, and I8 is negative, so going out of the node. So that is what we call coming into the node and going out of the node. So if the current is coming into the node, we say that it is positive. If the current is going out of the node, we say it is negative. Now let us talk about, suppose similarly you can write this KCL at node 2. So at node 2, if you see I2 is going out, so minus of I2, I5 is coming inside, so plus of I5, plus I4 and plus I3. So that is how you say that you have written a node equation, or you can say KCL equations at a particular node. So this KCL method gives us the way to analyze a circuit in terms of on the node basis, okay, or in terms of node analysis. So let us take a small circuit and try to apply KCL to it. So here, if you see, this is first we'll talk about the circuit itself. So there are two voltage sources here, then these are resistances, 2 ohm, 3 ohm, 4 ohm and 5 ohm. So current in 2 ohm, I'll call it as I2 ohm and so on. That is the way I am calling. So I2 ohm or I1 ohm or I3 ohm or I4 ohm or I5 ohm, that is how I'll call. And second thing is, as this is related to KCL and KCL is applied to currents, so here the sources are voltage. So here the voltage sources are convertible to current sources, okay? So we will first convert this and make the circuit full circuit in terms of currents only, okay, so that we can write current equations for each of them. You can write directly from this circuit also, but we'll talk about it later. First we take the fundamental things. So let us first convert this 12 volt and 2 ohm source and 6 volt and 4 ohm source into a proper circuit with a current source. So when you take voltage source conversion into account, so here if you remember the voltage source conversion, the current comes out to be 12 by 2, that is 6 amperes, and the same resistance comes into parallel. Okay, similarly this part, if you see 4 ohm and 6 volt, so that becomes 6 by 4, that is 1.5 amperes, and the resistance as it is comes in parallel to it. So if it is not convertible, if there is a circuit in which we are not able to convert this voltage sources and current sources, voltage sources into current source, or write the full circuit into current form, then you cannot write the KCL in a straightforward way. You can write for all the circuit KCL, but the way I am telling, the straightforward way is not possible if all the things are not given in current form, okay, current sources and current form. So we'll do it for this, and later on we'll see how to do for a general circuit. So here, if you see now, we have now a converted circuit. These are current sources, and if you see now, let us check how many nodes are there. So if you see, this all is one node, okay, this is one node. Then this is, if you see, this 4 ohm, this together is 1 ohm, this together is one node, okay. So V1, V2, two nodes are there. Then this hole qualifies to be a node because so many elements are connected to this, so this is V3. So there are three nodes, V1, V2 and V3, where we take one as a reference. So this node V3 here, we have taken it as a reference. You can take any one of them, but normally if you take this, there is some advantage. The advantage is there are so many things coming to it, and therefore you can say you have to write less number of algebraic variables. So that is what you advantage you can get, but you can take it is quite general, you can take any one of them as a reference node. So now let me see that how we can write the equations here. So I can draw here again in a nodal form, V1, node number V1. So if you see, this is V1, then if you see, if I write in the same form, this is 6 ampere coming into the node. I'm just trying to visualize the things in the way I have written the earlier KCL equation. So 6 amperes coming in, then there is a 2 ohm resistance through which there is I2 ohms coming in, okay. Then in this V1 there is one more resistance, 1 ohm resistance, and in this there is I1 ohm here, the direction is going out, and then there is another one here, 3 ohm resistance, in which I say I3 ohm is coming in, that is the direction, it is going out. So that is the direction we have taken, I3 going out. So if you see, this is the same circuit, similar circuit to what we have been doing, and now I can write KCL for this particular node. Say this is V1. So for this, if I want to write, first 6 ampere is coming in, then I2 is again coming in, I2 ohm is coming in, positive sign, I1 ohm is going out, so this is I1 ohm is going out, then it comes with a negative sign, then I3 ohm is again going out, so this was I3 ohm, that is going out, and all together they add up to 0. So I say that I have written a node equation for V1, okay. Now after writing that node equation, we can now substitute for what is I2, what is I1 and what is I3 ohms by taking the convention which we have already studied in earlier lecture. So if I want to calculate I2 ohms, okay, I2 ohm, if you see, one side is V1, other side is 0, okay, V3 is 0, so you can call it V3 or 0, and the current is flowing from V1 to V3 to V1, so it is going like this, this current I am talking about, and this is I3. And now if you remember that convention, I can write it as the current here as, or voltage current equation is, that this current I is equal to 0 minus V1 upon whatever is R, that is 2 ohm. So that is what is written here. It is same convention, if you remember, we took it in the when we were doing KVL equations, okay, convention. So This is for 2 ohm. Similarly, I can write for 1 ohm. Again, you can see it is coming from V1 to 0. So V1 minus 0 upon 4 is I1 ohm. Similarly, I3 is from V1 to V2. So that's why it is V1 to V2 and 3. And I am writing the current, keeping in the view the direction. I3 ohm is this direction. Okay. So V1 minus V2 upon 3. So this is how you have the node equation. And you can elegantly do it, combine the terms, okay? So 6 ohm is here and you can see that V1 is there. So I take out V1 and all the resistance connected to V1 will be coming together, okay? 1 by 2, 1 by 1, okay, this is 1, and 1 by 1 and 1 by 3. So whatever is connected to this V1, all the resistances are, in fact, if you try to solve the equation, this will be collected together so that you can connect to the circuit also directly. You can see to the circuit that this is happening, and this is coming with a negative sign. Then similarly, V2, whatever is there between V1 and V2, that is coming over here, V3, 1 by 3. So this is first equation. Similarly, you can try out the second equation for yourself. Okay, the second equation, I'll just see from here. If you see, 1.5 ohm is fit into the node, so again it is positive. Okay, 1.5 being fed into the node. Then other one is I4. If you see, I4 is going out of the node, so this together is one node. So I4 is going out of the node, so this is I4 ohm, and that's why it comes over here with a negative sign. Similarly, then I5, if you see, I5 is coming into the node, I5 ohm is coming into the node, and that's why it comes with a positive sign. Similarly, I3 ohm, if you see, is coming inside the node V2, and that is, you are writing for V2 only, so it is coming inside the V2, and therefore it becomes positive sign, plus I3 ohm. And then you can again substitute as you have done for earlier one, that is 1.5 is there and V2 by 4, so V2 minus 0 by 4 ohm, and 0 minus V2, 0 minus V2, so direction of the current is to be taken into account, and V1 minus V2 is I3, so I3 is coming, I3, if you see according to this direction, it is V1 minus V2, so I3 is V1 minus V2. And that is, if you again see, if you collect the term intelligently, you will see, you will get the current value here, then you will get V1 by 3, whatever is here, and then whatever is connected to V2, all the resistances are coming over here, okay? All the resistance, 1 by 4 is coming, 4 is here, 5 is here, this is no resistance, nothing is there, it is all together, okay? 4, 5 and 3. All those are connected to 2 are coming here, and 3 is coming again with V1, what is connected with 1 and 2. You need not write for V3 because we have assumed already that V3 is equal to 0. So this completes, in fact, the writing the equation for the circuit. Now we'll see how we can, just by collecting those terms, if you see, we can solve or we can write equation in a particular way. So this is equation number 1, okay? So all the resistances connected to node 1, and this is what is connected between 1 and 2, and that comes out to be 6 here. So the equation written in slightly different form. Similarly, if you see here, again V2 and 1 by 3 here, and all the resistances added together, 1 by 4, not resistances, you call it as admittances. When resistance is 1 by resistance, then it is admittance. So all the admittances are added together, 1.5, and I can write the equations in terms of a matrix. That is, this is a Y matrix giving you admittances of the circuit, and the voltages, that is number of nodes, if you know there are 2, we don't write for the third node or the reference node, and the current sources in the circuit. So there are 2 current sources fed to both the nodes. So number of nodes will decide how many current sources are there. If they are feeding into the node, then you call it as positive. If they are not feeding into the node, it is going out of the node, then it comes out to be negative. So that is same equations written in form of a matrix form. So that is how you can write a node equation. We'll also see that how the same can be written in form of a that's just by inspection. How can you can write this equations for this kind of circuits we have been talking. You can write this equation just by inspection. So we'll see that how to do that just after in the next part.